士师记没有记载作者是谁，根据犹太人的传统，认为作者是撒母耳。士师时代有多少年呢？目前没有定论，因为书卷记载各个士师的年份、时间不一定是按顺序，而且可能有重叠。有学者认为，士师记十一章二十六节提到，以色列人住在西什本已经有300年了，这间接证实了士师时代超过300年。另外有学者认为，以色列人进迦南的时间是在公元前1400年左右，征战了多年之后分了地业，开始士师时代，一直到扫罗被高利为王结束，大约是公元前1043年，这中间隔了350年。根据这些资料，我们倾向认为士师时代大约有300到350年左右。
The book of Judges beginning with who will go up for us into the land. And it's Judah, that's the focus. And so the reader is saying, okay, why is Judah the focus? Well, it just happens to be the tribe of kingship. And so by the time you get to the end, after the cycle of Judges that ends with Samson in chapter 16, you have these strange chapters, chapter 17 to 21. Well, they actually begin in chapter 17:6 and ends in 21:25 with this phrase, in those days there was no kings in Israel and every man did what was right in his own eyes.In the period of the section of chapter 17 to 21, you get the war with Benjamin, the Benjaminites, how they have committed a Sodom and Gomorrah type of act. And the tribes go up to fight them. And the question is asked, who will go up first and fight? And it's Judah again. My argument within the book and in the article I had written, I was saying that whoever is writing this and pulling this material together at a later date, probably during the period of David, he is trying to argue for,a particular type of kingship, that when you have civil war, because in the period of after the death of Saul and David coming to the throne, there was a period of almost 7 years of civil war when David ruled from Hebron, and there was really no active kingship for the United Monarchy because you have the Ish-bosheth, who is Saul's son, fighting with David's men, and it's chaos. And it's much like what's happening here at the end of the book of Judges. You're actually fighting each other as opposed to,fighting the Canaanites or fighting the Philistines. And I think that perhaps Abiathar the priest, because he would have been a literate individual, was probably writing at this time trying to convince the northern tribes to stop the civil war, that it's going to end up poorly. And Benjamin, as we read in that account in chapters 20 and 21, Benjamin's decimated to the point of 600 men. And they have killed all the women and children. They have to go and basically take by force women to marry Benjaminites.And this is the situation that I'm sure Abiathar and David is sensing. If the civil war that's going on is going to continue, this is the way we're going to end up. And in those days when there was no kings in the land, this is what happens, chaos. Now let's get the proper king. The proper king is David. Why don't we all get together, make David our king, not Benjamin, not Saul and his line, but make David as the king, and everything will smooth out. And there will be law, there will be order, there will be no more chaos.
一般的了解当然士师记之后就是撒母耳记，然后呢士师时期跟着来的呢就是王国时期，所以一般的了解呢就是士师记最后这里这样讲呢，就是说呢士师时期是一个混乱的时期，黑暗的时期，士师记是盼望王国时期的来到，使到以色列人呢是有那個的秩序啊，有興盛啊，但是我自己如果單單從士師記本身來看的話，我自己會有一些不同的感受，因為君王在士師記裏面都有出現的，特別前面呢我們發覺有君王，第一章就有了，有君王的出現，不過那些君王呢是指迦南地那些的君王，这些君王呢给我们的形象呢就是欺压百姓的，欺压以色列人的一些的形象， 是不好的形象。基甸打敗了米甸人之後，那那些以色列人是要立這個基甸作王的？咁啊，基甸话：我唔做你嘅王，因为耶和华先至系你哋嘅王。表面嚟睇咧，佢唔要作王嘅，但系从圣经嘅记载本身嚟睇咧，佢似乎系作咗王啦。因为第一，佢咪立咗以弗德做个偶像嘅，啊，就一个嘅宗教嘅信仰啦。好多时候政治都会利用宗教嘅，咁啊，所以咧。基甸呢立这个的以弗德就要为他作王的一个的行动来。后来呢圣经告诉他他有一个仔叫做亚比米勒。亚比米勒的意思就是说我爸爸是王的意思。每一个人他爸爸就是基甸咯。所以基甸是王。基甸帮他起个名字这样的意思岂不是反映基甸本身是王吗？咁啊，我哋睇见基甸如果系真系做王嘅时候，咁就需要有继承人啦。咁佢嘅继承人咧，圣经嘅记载就系亚比米勒。亚比米勒为咗要争夺呢个王位，将基甸其他所有嘅儿子都杀咗，带俾基甸呢个家族一个极大嘅悲哀。后嚟佢自己本身统治以色列人，亦都一塌糊涂，最收尾被人杀咗啦。咁我哋发觉咧，王啊喺士师嘅本身，其实个形象系差嘅，唔系正面嘅。咁所以从士师嘅本身嚟睇嘅话，王其实系唔好嘅。咁啊，点解士师嘅到最收尾嘅时候会提到呢个王咧？啊，出埃及第十五章啊，当佢哋出埃及过咗红海之后，佢哋系唱歌赞美神嘅歌。那首歌到了最收尾的时候，他们是高举耶和华作他们的王的。所以呢，在他们的信仰当中呢，神是他们的王，所以他们迟迟都不会立王。就算呢，当时那些长老要求撒母耳要帮他们立王的时候，撒母耳不高兴了。那去到上帝那时，上帝都不高兴的。上帝说他们不是拒绝你，撒母耳，是拒绝我作他们的王。所以从理想来讲，以色列人在圣经里面，就是人作为王是不好的。所以呢，这个王在士师里面的了解，最少我自己的了解呢，如果你了解成为耶和华神呢，可能会更加好一点。
Well, when we think about the overarching theme of the Book of Judges, several things come to mind. One is that what type of government is preferable? Is it a monarchy? Is it a democracy? Is it a republic? Because we see in the period of the Judges that there was no king, and God told them, you don't need a king. I'll rule over you. You will have a decentralized type of government. Ultimately, they rebelled against that. And you get a transitional character in Samuel who sort of transitions into the period of the kings. But they choose a monarchy over a theocracy. And I think about in our world today, we have many forms of government. There's no one biblical form of government. And that's, to me, one message of the Book of Judges as well, is that God wants to rule over our lives, and we shouldn't look to a certain form of human government, and because governments rise and governments fall, but the kingdom of God continues to advance.
当时候的迦南人和环境对以色列人有很大的引诱和压力的。引诱最大的呢就是信仰，因为迦南人相信的就是巴力，还有迦南地还有圣经里面都提到有其他的偶像，无论巴力也好，其他偶像也好，偶像所代表的呢就是那些人的欲望，你想乜嘢嘢，你就会拜乜嘢嘢，或者你所相信、你所拜嘅、所反映嘅，就系你自己嘅欲望。所以就算今日虽然我哋话啲人咧都唔拜菩萨啦，但系其实佢哋 係追求緊嘅嗰啲嘅慾望，我哋可以話係無形嘅一啲嘅偶像咧，嚟到成為佢哋崇拜敬拜嘅一啲嘅對象。每個話嚟講咧，信仰同埋佢哋嘅現實生活咧係有息息相關嘅。咁今日亦都係咁樣啊，表面上邊我哋好似乎睇唔到信仰咧同埋我哋嘅生活有啲咩好好直接嘅嗰個嘅關係，但係四書記話俾我哋聽，信仰同我哋嘅生活咧係有不可分割嘅嗰種嘅關係嘅。我哋所相信嘅，亦都會影響我哋嘅生活。我哋點樣相信，就會影響我哋嘅生活。就好似以色列人咧拜偶像追求啊迦南人所敬拜嘅神嘅時候，佢哋受到迦南人嘅欺壓。同樣啊，我哋今日嘅人，如果我哋係只係掛住追求慾望，咁樣反過嚟咧，呢個世界嘅慾望就會成為我哋嘅欺壓者。
Another one is when we compare their views. If you were only to read Joshua by itself, you would come away thinking that the conquest happened lightning fast, that they went through the land and they destroyed all these enemies and they consolidated power. And in reality, that's true. In 7 years' time, they had primarily completed the initial phase of the conquest. But then if you were to read Judges, having not read Joshua, you would come away with a very different picture.You would come away thinking that the conquest took hundreds of years. You know, there were these enemies that held on for generations, you know, many generations, and people they were not able to conquer. And they seem to be in conflict. You have a lightning fast conquest, and then you have one that takes centuries. How do we harmonize those two? And I think there is a perfect harmonization. It is true that the Israelites conquered these major Canaanite urban cities, and that within 7 years they had consolidated and gotten a foothold in the land.But it took hundreds of years for them to complete that work of possessing their possessions and inheriting their inheritance. And I think the parallel for us spiritually is that when we consider sanctification, when we give our lives to God, He begins a work of sanctification in us that's very fast. Some things change right away when we become believers. Other things change very slowly over years and over decades of our lives.So we would say in theological terms that sanctification is both instantaneous and progressive. And I think that's how Joshua and Judges are when we juxtapose them, when we set them side by side. The conquest is instantaneous, but then it's also progressive. And so that's another, I think, big message from the two books.
播种国际事工，邀请您与我们携手前行。是撒种的有种，是要吃的有粮。了解更多详情，请洽播种国际。